Hello, this is Ehtisham Shahid from Arabiya English. Happy New Year and welcome to a new series called Bridging Divides. In this series, I'll raise certain issues and challenges facing the developing world, add a bit of context and then leave it to your good judgment. Today, we are going to discuss a very serious issue called the distressed farmer. Among the various divides witnessed around the world today, between the haves and the have-nots, the rich and the poor, the gender divide, the digital divide. There's one that isn't discussed that often, the rural-urban divide. One major reason attributed to the defeat of the ruling BJP in India's Hindi heartland states recently was the distressed farmer. They were unhappy with crop yields, lack of government support, and general neglect of the agriculture sector. While India has done reasonably well across various economic indicators in recent decades, challenges such as making the farming sector self-reliant and ensuring market access for agricultural products haven't yet been overcome. As a result, 300,000 farmers have committed suicide in India in the last 10 years alone. According to Down to Earth magazine, 15,000 farmers commit suicide every year in India, which is around 40 every day. India, as we know, is an agrarian economy, with around 70% of its rural household depending directly or indirectly on agriculture sector. Farmers commit suicide elsewhere too, but it's not as rampant as it is in India. This state of affairs raises many questions. Can any country afford to lose so many lives, that too of people who feed them? Is it just about allocation of resources? As some countries have the money to resolve farmers' challenges, but choose to invest in other areas, such as defense, for instance. Is this talk of technology coming to farmers' rescue a mere hogwash, or hasn't helped countries like India? Another major dilemma is the farm subsidies. Should we, shouldn't we, how much is enough? But here is a broader, perhaps more pressing question. Is the plight of farmers being ignored just because they live in the countryside and not in amid our fancy cities or corridors of power? Is it a case of away from sight, away from mind? Think about it and get in touch via my Twitter handle @E2Sham. See you in another episode of Bridging Divides with Arabiya English.